Hello, everybody, and welcome to Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. A very big welcome to everybody joining us on Facebook, everybody joining us on YouTube, anybody who is returning, and a massive welcome to any new viewers today. This is Pronunciation Live, which is the show where you send in the words that you have difficulty pronouncing. So before we begin, please get in the comments box and let us know where in the world you are joining us from. And I will get to the comments in just a moment. So before we begin, just to make sure that if you do have a pair of headphones, please pop them in. This is a pronunciation show, and hearing the sounds nice and clearly will really help you. So if you pop your headphones in and turn the volume up nice and loud. If you don't have a pair of headphones, then just make sure you turn up the volume as loud as possible. Secondly, this is a pronunciation show, so we won't be focusing on word meaning. You probably will come across some new vocabulary today, so do make a note of any new vocabulary, and you can check the definition after the show in a dictionary. And finally, please don't forget that there are different accents in English. I have an accent that is maybe typical of the northwest of England, but you will hear English pronounced in different ways. So don't worry, there are more similarities than differences, but just bear in mind that there is not one way to correctly pronounce everything in English. All right, let's get to the comments and see who we've got here. We have got Hiba from Egypt, a big welcome to you, and Adela Silo from Angola. Hello, we've got Badri, the best teacher in the club. Thank you very much, Badri. You're a fantastic student as well, in my opinion. Ahmed from Yemen, a very big hello and welcome to you. Lekshemi, welcome back from Kerala. Fantastic to see you, as well as Siraj from Pakistan. Big hello. Hello to Wolczek and everybody who is joining us from Poland. And Solwu, a big hello to you and all our viewers in Korea. A big welcome. We have got, I can't read your name, but a big welcome to you from Nepal. Hello, Ruth. Hello, Professor. Hello, Ruth. Back to you. Thank you for joining us. We've got Akim from Morocco. Hello to Bithi from Bangladesh. And Soothing also from Bangladesh. We have got Salah from Kurdistan. Thank you for joining us. We've got Iyas from Oman. Usman from Pakistan, a very big welcome to you. And Merle from the Philippines, as well as Fatih from Turkey. Fantastic. Great to see so many of you joining us from so many different places. Okay. Let's have a look. Just a moment. Oops. Sorry, we've also got Diana from Buenos Aires. Fantastic. So many different places. This is great. And Adam from Burkina Faso. A very, very big welcome to everybody. Now, before we begin with the words that you have sent in, let's just take a look at today's challenge. So today's challenge is some words that were sent in by Bakit, you, Biju, Tangina, and Shamsunaha. So thank you very much for sending in these fantastic words before the show. Which of these words do not have a sh sound? So very often this sound is made with the letters sh, and the sound is sh. And I've put in the symbol for those that can read that as well. So sometimes you will see this sound represented in this squiggle shape, and the sound is sh. But which of these words does not have the sh sound in it? Okay, what do you think? So Asad thinks there is no sh sound in this word, and Adlinda thinks there is no sh sound in this word. And we have got Ghassan. I like your profile picture very much, Ghassan, who thinks the answer is E, so there is no sh in this word. We've got Daniel who thinks C. We've got VM who thinks E. This student would agree with you with E. Gunel thinks it is B and E. Interesting, Gunel. Would you agree? Milan thinks this word does not have a sh sound. And Salvador thinks E. Tran agrees with you. E. Nura thinks B. Satu thinks D. Patrick thinks E. There might be more than one correct answer. So as always, I will come back to today's challenge at the end of the show. Show, a word with SH sound in it. Sh. And we will see which of these words does not have an SH sound, and we will practice the pronunciation. As you can see, none of these words have the letters SH, but some of them do have a sh sound. Okay, how is absolutely sure? B, 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 B. Simone thinks D. Verica thinks E. So we will come back and we will take a look at these at the end of the show. Okay, let's go back to today's comments and just see what you've sent in. So let me just take the challenge off. There we go. Krishnan says, in fast speech, how do we say these? So I got a photo shoot done. I got a photo shoot done. If we say this quickly, we would say, I got a photo shoot done. I got a photo shoot done. So got and become gotta. I got a photo shoot done. Reluctant to report to authorities. Okay, so in fast speech, Krishnan, reluctant to report to authorities. And finally, he said that the migraine is getting worse. It should be worse with a E at the end here. He said that the migraine is getting worse. So you can hear that some of the letters at the ends of words are often dropped. So instead of getting with a G sound at the end, it's very common to say getting in fast speech. So we would drop the G sound there. So I hope that helps. Elvin would like to practice examples of schwa. So Elvin, I will focus on this throughout the show where I can, where we have this schwa. For those that don't know, schwa just means the sound, which is very common in English because it's very easy to say. So instead of a cup of tea, it's very common that we would say a cup of tea. So a becomes a. And of becomes of, so of. So we'll focus on those, Elvin, and see if we can find some more examples of the sound, the schwa sound. Fantastic. All right. So another question as well we had from Inga, who when asked what words they wanted help practicing, the answer was, I don't even know. I speak English well, but I don't like my accent. How can I get the British accent, please? Well, one thing to remember is it's not bad to have your own accent. Your accent tells people where you come from. But if you do want to sound more British or modern received pronunciation, you've come to the right place. So one of the first things you can do is listen to words in British English and repeat them. Even though we only look at some words today, this will help you start with the pronunciation. And when you learn other words in English, you will be able to hear those pronunciation sounds as well. And of course, watching lots of British TV shows and films and copying how you hear the sounds. But don't forget that there are many different accents in Britain. So you need to focus on the one that you want. All right, let's take a look at the words today. So we have got Hussein, who has sent in artichoke. Artichoke, so a type of vegetable, and zucchini. So the CH here makes a K sound, zucchini, but this is another vegetable. This word is much more common in North American English, and in British English, we would say courgette with a zh sound here, courgette. And Hussein, your other word is utter. Some people might pronounce the more, so they might say utter. I would say utter, which means to say something out loud. It also means very, okay. So complete or absolute, utter. Shay, your word is veterinarian. So quite a difficult word to say there. I'll break it down again. Veterinarian. veterinarian. But if you're finding that difficult, don't worry, you can just say vet and it has the same meaning. Back it, your words are see and see, which are homophones, which means they have the same pronunciation. See, we've got environment, environment, and we've also got prayer. So this has the same sound as the word air, air, and then just add a pr at the beginning. So you've got prayer, prayer, prayer. So we can't hear the Y sound in there at all. Thank you for sending those words in, everybody. Okay, let's take a look at some of the comments. So we've got education. Education, so it's education, but we might say this quickly, education, education. So we've got this sound again in the middle. Oh, Marizo, I hope this isn't something that you are suffering from. This word is diarrhea, diarrhea, a difficult word to pronounce when you look at it because the spelling seems quite crazy. That is diarrhea, diarrhea. Okay, let's have a look here. How this word is supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Okay, a very long word in English. If you're a fan of Mary Poppins, you might know this word. Mohammed, we've got interjection. 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 I hope that helps. What else have we got here? Let's take a look. Oops, we've had education already. And Lisbeth, your word is harmful, harmful, harmful. So if something is dangerous, we could say it is harmful. It is harmful. Evgeny, the RP accent, something called received pronunciation, is now called the BBC accent. It used to be. So in history on the BBC, they would only use a specific accent, which is what we call RP in English. But now that's not true. On the BBC, you can hear all different accents so that all parts of the country and the English speaking world are represented. So but Evgeny, you're not wrong. That was something that RP was referred to before in the past. Okay, let's have a look here. We've got self-contradictory. Self-contradictory. We've also got possess. Possess. So we've got a Z, like a Z sound in the middle here, Mikola. Possess. And also processor. So here is an S sound in the middle, processor, processor. I hope that helps. Modesta, when people meet, we often use the word rendezvous, which comes from French, but it is a word in English as well. And the pronunciation is more similar to a French pronunciation, rendezvous, rendezvous. Rendezvous. Cassia, vet is the same meaning as veterinarian. Yes. So that's why I said if you can't say veterinarian, you can just say vet. That would hopefully make it a bit easier for you. Okay. Mohammed, your words are promptly. So to do something quickly, you do it promptly. We've also got the word you, which is the same pronunciation as me and you. Okay, you, which means a female sheep, and enthusiastic. Okay, so we've got that TH, which is difficult for some learners of English. Enthusiastic. You just got to touch your tongue to your teeth. Enthusiastic. Enthusiastic. Okay. Vitalia, you're watching to learn how to pronounce new words in a British accent. That's great. How do we pronounce the word chew? This word is chew. So if you make a ch, ch, this ch sound in English, ch, and then oo, chew, chew. Hope that helps. Amar, your words are older, older. So if you make a ol with shape with your mouth, older, and order, order, order. Amna, your word is mathematics. Okay, so again, we've got this TH sound in the middle here. Mathematics, mathematics. Very good. And this word can be difficult because we've got a B that we don't hear, and the word, the pronunciation is doubt. So it rhymes with out, out, doubt. So just put a D sound before the word out, and you have doubt. Don't worry about the B in there. We can't hear that being pronounced at all. And when your word is pierce, P-E-A-R-C-E, pierce, pierce. And Amjad, your word is democracy. Democracy. Hope that helps. And Srinath, your word is narcissist. So lots of S sounds in here. Narcissist. Narcissist. If you are just joining us, this is Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English, the word where, sorry, the show where you send in words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. A big thank you to everybody who has sent in words before the show, but don't worry if you didn't have time. Please add your words to the comment box and I will get through as many today as I can. If you are enjoying the show as well, please don't forget to hit that like button. If you are loving the show, then please don't forget to hit that heart button and feel free to share the show with friends, family, teachers, students, anybody that you think might benefit from a little pronunciation practice. So, Bakit sent in this word before these words before the show. We've got C and C. Oh, we saw these ones already, Packet. Thank you very much. Sorry. We have got Amar. Your words are characteristics, character, characteristics, hierarchical, hierarchical. So things that are organized in order are hierarchical. Law. So this is an or sound with a l at the beginning. Law. The opposite of high is low. So, or, law, o, low. We've got aren't. So, are not is aunt. And that has the same pronunciation as your mother or father's sister, your aunt. Although you do hear some people say aunt, like the animal, but usually aunt. And we've got ain't, ain't, and we've got eon. Thank you for sending those in. Des, your word is two ways to pronounce this one. People have difficulty with this, so don't worry, Des. It's either February, February. So we take the R in the middle out, so it becomes February. Or you can pronounce the R February. February. So some people say February, some people say February. I think I would say February myself with a y sound in the middle. It's up to you. Choose which one you find easiest and you can stick with that one. Zaro, thank you again for joining us and for your super polite message that you sent along with these words. We've got hare, hare, so a large rabbit, hare. We've also got hare, hare, herd. And air. Okay, so the last word rhymes with hair and hair, but we don't pronounce the H and it is air. Air. Okay, so hair, herd, and air. All right, let's go back to today's challenge and ask the question again. Which of these words do not have a sh sound? So typically a sound made with the letters SH. None of these words have the letters SH, but which of them make a sh or have a, sorry, which of them do not have a sh sound in the middle? So Graziella is absolutely sure it is D. Manzi thinks it is B and E. Lynn thinks it's A and E. Enga thinks D and E. Monica agrees, maybe, is not sure, Monica, but thinks possibly D and E as well. VMG thinks it is E. Claudia thinks D and E. Brain thinks it is B and E. And Manzi would agree with you, whereas Ak thinks it is just E. Hasmik agrees with you as well that it is B and E. So we will take a look at these at the end of the show and we will practice the pronunciation there. Okay, Faisal would like to know how to pronounce exchange, exchange, excuse. So we've got a U here in the middle, X. So to make that X, you need to make a K, like a K, K sound, followed by a S, like an S sound. So if you imagine a K and an S together, X, excuse, and then you've got a U sound after that. We've also got exam, exam. So again, a K and a S sound together, exam. And examine, examine, excited. But the last one here is anxiety. So the X here does not make a X sound. It makes a Z sound, like a Z. So anxiety, anxiety. Thank you. Rajib, your word is subtle, subtle. So again, like the word doubt, a silent B here. The word is subtle, subtle. I hope that helps you. Let's have a look here. So Deepthi, your words are or, and debt. So just like doubt and subtle, we've also got a silent B here. So this word is debt. Debt. This is when you spend more money than you have. Hopefully you are not in debt. Okay, Ishrat, assume, assume, and assurance, assurance. So in this second word, there is no SH, but we do have a sh sound. Okay, assurance, assurance. Hope that helps. Let's have a look at this word, Abdul Muttalib. Your word is gentrified, gentrified. So it's a soft G at the beginning, gen, gentrified, gentrified. And Alwyn, your word is asthma, asthma. So you can just make an S sound. You don't have to try to make the TH sound here. Just say asthma, asthma, asthma. Okay, good. And Riman, your word is adapt. Adapt, adapt. Okay. Let's have a look at Dipthi. Do you say confidence instead of confidence? Confidence, confidence, confidence. It's not quite an M sound, but the N is soft. So confidence, confidence, confidence. So not quite with an M, but it is a very soft N sound in there. Thank you for your question. And Swadesh, in this word, is the T silent. Sometimes it is pronounced and sometimes it is not pronounced. So you can say often, often, or you can say often, often. And very often, the same speaker might sometimes say often and sometimes say often. It doesn't really matter where you're from. It just gets pronounced in both ways. And Americus, your word is acknowledgement, acknowledgement. Okay, so we might have the word acknowledgement, and this part is pronounced acknowledgement. All right, let's have a look at some of the words that were sent in before the show. So Ming Fong had been watching a BBC Learning English video and had come across the sentence, "I might have a new job." I might have a new job. Now, in fluent English, have often becomes have. And we also often drop the H at the beginning, so it becomes of. So here you might hear, I might have a new job. I might have a new job. I might have a new job. And Ming's question was, she thought that might have had actually been shortened to Maiva, I Maiva new job. Ming, it's not common that this would happen. I think it's just that the speaker was speaking so quickly that it maybe sounded like that, but all the sounds are in there. I might have a new job. I might have a new job. But when we speak quickly, it is very difficult to hear those sounds. Spring, your words are gravitate towards. Gravitate towards. Can you hear how gravitate and towards, the t are very close together, so you need to say them quite quickly. Gravitate towards, gravitate towards. And your other word here is repetitive, repetitive, repetitive. Okay, you sent in these words. Your first word is on today's challenge. So we're going to come back and have a look at how these words, do they sound similar? Do they sound different? Your second here is word is virgin. Virgin. So they both begin with the same sound, ver. And your second word ends with gin. So we've got virgin. We're going to look at your first word when we come back to today's challenge at the end of the show. Dulandali, your word is poor. So it's p or poor. Poor. Hope that helps. And Mufaso, your word is adjust. And you wanted to know if there was any set silent letter. We don't hear the D really in adjust because just kind of has a D sound at the beginning. So it's just adjust, 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 adjust. Hope that helps. And Shum Sunaha, thank you for sending in these words. Your words are, I'm not going to say the first one because that is in today's challenge. So we'll take a look at that in a moment. And we've got Oxford, English. And the city of Dhaka. So Oxford, English, and Dhaka. Biju, some fantastic food words here. Most of these words come from Italian because they are Italian foods. And we try in English to keep the same pronunciation when we borrow words from other languages, but they won't be exactly the same. So here we've got spaghetti, spaghetti. Now, you have two Z's in the middle of pizza, but it's not a Z sound, it's a ts. So if you make a T sound t, with a s, so a T sound and an S sound, t, s, and put those together, you get ts. Pizza, pizza. And the same happens in mozzarella, mozzarella. Mozzarella, but lasagna does have a Z sound where the S is lasagna. So we've got spaghetti, pizza, mozzarella, and lasagna. And BG, one of my favorite foods, I put this on too much to be honest, is mayonnaise. Mayonnaise, mayonnaise. And again, if you find mayonnaise difficult to say, we often just say mayo. Shuja, your words are trepidation, trepidation, renaissance, renaissance, trenchant, trenchant, and tutelage, tutelage. Hope that helps. And Amar, your words are cool, cool, and allure, allure. Okay, hope that helps. And Lekha, thank you for sending this in before the show. Your word is knowledgeable, knowledgeable, knowledgeable. So I hope that helps. Okay. Lakshmi, your words here are birthday, birthday, and water. Mikola, antibiotic, antibiotic, and schedule. And Balanli, your word is receipt. So this does have a silent letter. There is no p sounds here. Receipt, receipt, receipt. We'll take a quick look at the months of the year, Shakib. We've got January, February, or February, as I modeled earlier. March, March, April, May, June. So this j sound again, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. All right, the show will be recorded and you can watch it again if you would like to slow that down and have a few have another practice with the days, sorry, the months of the year. Okay, so if you have just joined us, this is Pronunciation Live. Don't worry, the show is recorded, as I mentioned, and you can go back and watch this on YouTube or Facebook starting from the beginning, and you can pause it and you can take your time to practice pronouncing all the words that have been modeled today. So let's take a look again at today's challenge. Which of these words do not have a sh sound in them? Which of these words do not? So we're going to take a look at the answer. Manzi thinks the answer is B and E. Many of you think the answer is E. So Krishnan agrees, Fan agrees, Claudia thinks it is D and E. And Brian is like, or Brain, sorry, is B, 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 D, 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 E, 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 is absolutely sure of these three. So before we take a look at the answer, let me read the words to you and see if you can hear a sh sound in the middle there. So we've got invitation, version, traditional, pistachio, and psychological. So invitation, version, traditional, pistachio, and psychological. So, what were the correct answers? They were B and E. Fantastic to anybody who, like Nuher, correctly said B and E. Absolutely fantastic. Okay, almost Cecilia. So, not D. So, here the CH does make a sh sound and not a ch sound. But you did get E correct. Well done. And Primavera, you also got E correct. Shakib, you also got E correct. And Kazi Rabbi, you got B correct. So let's just take another look. Invitation, very often T-I-O-N at the end of words gives you a sh sound. So invitation and traditional. And a strange word here, the CH in pistachio makes a sh sound, which is very common for words that we take from French. So French words that have CH that we use in English very often have a sh, like chauffeur, for example. But version, so you sent in the words version and virgin. It's not a sh sound, it's a zh, zh sound. So version. And psychological doesn't have any SH sound. So, a very big congratulations and well done if you got that correct. Rahila missed B. Don't worry, you got E. You're halfway there. Just keep practicing and please do join us again on Pronunciation Live at 1:30 every Tuesday and Thursday. Send in your words before the show or during the show and we will get through as many as we can. If you have enjoyed today's show, please don't forget to hit that like button or hit that heart button or share the show with all your friends, family, anybody who you think might benefit from improving their pronunciation. Thank you so much for your hard work today. Great to see so many of you, and I will see you all next time. All right, take care.